Hello and welcome back to lecture 2.2 on 2D geometry. In this video, I will introduce the basic concepts of 2D points and lines, and we will discuss how to transform these entities using 2D transformations. As you all know, we can represent 2D points as a 2D vector, which we will denote by a boldface X. This vector has two components, x and y, which represent the coordinates of this 2D point. We can also represent the same 2D point by what's called an augmented vector. This is a 3D vector where the first two components represent this point, the coordinates, and the third component is just one. This vector we will denote by x bar. At a first glance, this makes things more complicated, seemingly, but as we will see in this video, it actually simplifies calculations, such as intersecting lines and points, and such as representing transformations of these points in terms of simple matrix vector products. Furthermore, we can introduce a representation for 2D points, the same 2D point, by what's called homogeneous coordinates, sometimes also called projective coordinates. These are 3D vectors that have three independent components, but the key idea is that two homogeneous vectors that only differ by scale actually represent the same 2D point. We can then convert back from homogeneous to inhomogeneous coordinates simply by dividing through the last element. So here, for example, if you have a homogeneous vector with components x tilde, y tilde, and w tilde, dividing by the last component w tilde gives you back the 2D coordinates x and y that representing this point. In particular, of course, with homogeneous coordinates, w tilde can become zero. Assume we have a point x tilde with these three components, and we now let w tilde go to zero, then the point coordinates x and y of this point move towards infinity. And so for w tilde equals zero, these points are called points at infinity or ideal points, and they then, in fact, represent a direction in space. We can represent lines, as you all know, by some offset from the origin and some direction of the line. In this class, we will use a homogeneous coordinate vector L tilde to represent lines. It contains three components A, B, C. And the idea is that any point on the line, written in this augmented vector x bar, is an element is on the line if and only if it is orthogonal to L tilde. So the scalar product of x bar and L tilde, being just ax plus by plus c, must be zero. Of course, again, as with homogeneous coordinates for points here as well, two vectors represent the same line if they only differ by scaling. In particular, this allows us to define a normalized line equation where the homogeneous coordinate vector L tilde representing the line is chosen such that the first two components define the normal vector, so a unit vector being that is orthogonal to the line. And then the third component here, D, is simply the offset from the origin. With homogeneous coordinates, we can very easily define a line connecting two points. So if we represent these two points, x1 and x2, in terms of homogeneous coordinates, then the line connecting them is simply given by the cross product of the homogeneous coordinate vectors. Similarly, if we want to define the intersection of two lines represented in homogeneous coordinates by L1 tilde and L2 tilde, then the point in their intersection is given by the cross product of these two vectors. And so here you can see how things like intersecting points, intersecting lines or connecting points with a line can be very easily done in homogeneous or projective coordinates. Similarly, these projective coordinates help to model 2D transformations of points or lines. Here, the simplest transformation you can think of is a 2D translation. That is, a vector x is translated to a vector x prime simply by adding an offset vector t. That's a 2D vector representing this offset. We can represent the same transformation as a matrix vector product once we write the vector x in as an augmented vector, again the third component being 1. Then this x plus t can be written as a matrix vector product with a 2x3 matrix where the first block is an identity matrix and the last column is the 2D translation vector t. If we write both the input and output in homogeneous coordinates, x tilde and x tilde prime, then the transformed vector is obtained from the original vector x tilde by a matrix multiplication with a 3x3 matrix that contains in the upper left corner an identity matrix. The upper right part of the last column is the translation vector, and below we have zeros and one. We can generalize the translation by adding a rotation. This leads to what's called a rigid body motion or a Euclidean transformation. And in standard 2D coordinates, we can write it as Rx plus T. In homogeneous coordinates, again, we can just write it as a matrix vector product, where the upper left-hand corner is the rotation matrix R, containing cosine and sine for a 2D transformation of this angle theta, the rotation angle. So this is an orthogonal matrix, i.e. R transpose is 1 and it has determinant plus 1. And again, in this matrix, the 3x3 matrix defining this Euclidean transform, the upper right-hand corner we have the translation vector T. It's actually quite useful that you can write transformations as matrix vector products because it allows you to very elegantly concatenate transformations. So if you concatenate two rigid body transformations, then it simply amounts to a matrix product of the two matrices. Rigid body transformations are transformations which preserve distances and angles. And vice versa, one can actually show that any transformation which does preserve distances and angles is invariably a rotation plus translation. We can generalize this rigid body transformation by introducing a scaling by a scalar little s here. And that leads to what's called a similarity transform that consists of a translation and the scaled rotation. We can write it again in homogeneous coordinates as a matrix vector product where the upper left hand corner is the scaled rotation matrix S times R. Similarity transforms no longer preserve lengths because of a potentially non-uniform scaling S, but they still preserve angles as shown in the upper right-hand side, so a square, for example, can be transformed to a rectangle. We can further generalize the similarity transform by replacing the rotation matrix in the upper left-hand corner by an arbitrary matrix, 2x2 matrix. And this leads to what's called an affine transformation. As you can see, in homogeneous coordinates, this transformation has 6 parameters, and In particular, what is preserved in an affine transformation is that parallel lines remain parallel. So angles are no longer preserved in general, scales or lengths is not preserved, but parallel lines remain parallel. We can further generalize the affine transformation to the most generic 2D linear transformation, and that in homogeneous coordinates, and that is the so-called homography or projective transformation, and that can be written by a matrix large H tilde, which is a homography matrix, and this is a 3x3 matrix containing 9 elements. But you should remember that we're working in homogeneous coordinates, meaning that two vectors are identical if they only differ by scaling. That implies that for two homography matrices, if they only differ by scaling, they actually correspond to the same projective transformation. What is preserved in a homography or in a projective transformation is that straight lines remain straight lines. So as you can see here in the upper right-hand drawing, in the homography transformation of the rectangle, parallel lines do not have to remain parallel, but straight lines will always remain straight. What have we learned in this video and lecture? We learned about 2D points and 2D lines. In particular, we learned about homogeneous or projective coordinates for points and lines, and we saw that these coordinates drastically facilitate the study of 2D transformations. In particular, we studied transformations like the translation, the rigid body motion, the similarity transformation, the affine transformation, and the most general case, the homography or projective transformation. In the next video, we will study these entities and aspects on a particular example, and this will then lead us to an exercise where you can learn to apply these techniques in geometry.